Hey guys, I'm here with a video, and today I'm doing the Energon Autobot Air Team, which you can also call the Aerial Bots. The way the Energon Combiner Teams work is there are basically three figures, or three distinct molds per combiner set. You're going to have your central core figure, then you're going to have two of the same of one, and then two of the same for the other. So you've got three different figures. They kind of broke those up into have five figures. I wish they would have kind of gone all out. So, since these guys are the same, I've kind of worked things out a little way. I'm going to review them kind of in pairs. Should be easy, I hope. Here we have Sky Shadow, and here we have Terra Dive. I think the weapon's popping off. They are both A10 Thunderbolt 2s. Not bad looking in terms of, you know, whole vehicle modes. I've gone ahead and attached the Energon weapon to the top here. It is basically this thing right here. If it's done to create a kind of a little gun for the top, it's okay. It's nothing bad, I guess. But here you have the A10 Thunderbolt 2. Looks pretty nice. He has some landing gears in the bottom. The wheels do not turn. You can fold the wheels away. He has a cannon on the front, and he has a rotating type turret on the bottom, which can pivot all the way around. Although if you open it too much, hey, look at its eyes. Now to transform these into their robot modes, gonna start by undoing these back sections here, undo those. Those are gonna be his arms later on, so just kinda leave them dangling. Going to the front here, undo this, undo that. Spin this up, and as you spin it, go ahead and bring the head up along with it, so it's not in the way, and that's gonna go in place. The head's gonna lock down to the neck. This one, you kinda gotta push, and his goggles will pop off excessively, especially if they are kind of used. I'm wondering, you know, how many of my little complaints with these guys is because they're so old, because I got this guy used on eBay, so who knows what he's seen. Who knows? So go ahead and you're gonna rotate his legs. Remember what I said in the Nexus Maximus video, 'cause it's the same guy. Two goes in the back. Nothing in the front. Go ahead and split the legs down the middle. Then you're going to rotate them so he has his knees in the front. Rotate the feet so he has little ankles. Rotate his arms so the elbows in the front. And, you know, you can leave his wings kind of like this. You can't leave them all the way back. You can leave them all the way deployed like this. You may want to kind of leave him in the middle. But then you have Sky Shadow. Looks okay. I hear my cat whining. That's never a good thing. But get him standing there. He does stand fairly well. Maybe. I don't know why he's not doing it today. Maybe. I don't know. Okay, he stands. So now to transform a Terra Dive, and there he is. You know, these guys really aren't horrible. I think it's kind of cool that he has this little face. You can flip down. These either be goggles or to give him these nice little laser goggle type things. His Energon weapon is already transformed from his plane mode. You're just going to fold it into itself. And it fits right into a little hole in his hands. And it should fit. It's a little... There we go. Give him this nice little gun. He has an Energon star, which all of these smaller four figures come with. Energon star comes off and you have a nice little Autobot logo on the inside of his chest. Not a bad little guy. In terms of articulation, the legs are on their own ball joints, so you can kind of get a lot of posability with them all the way around. He has knee joints, his feet can move, he has ankle joints. All those, you can rotate the knee, you can rotate his hip. The arms, they can pivot outwards, they're on their own ball joint. Elbows on a ball joint. The wrist does not turn, but oh well. And his head can go a full 360. And the goggles can do that. So, there's Terra Dive and Sky Shadow. That's two down. It's not bad. Making a good time, I think. I'm going to skip Storm Jet because he's going to come later. I'm going to go ahead and do Treadshot. Now, Treadshot and I believe it's Windrazor are both the same vehicles. They are pretty much Cybertronian jets. Every website I've seen just says fighter jet. Jet fighter, Cybertronian jet, Cybertronian jet fighter. So, they're Cybertronian jets, apparently. Not too bad. You can attach the Energon weapons to the wings like that. Give them this little look, which I don't know why you would do it. It looks okay. But, anyway. He, too, has landing gears all through here. You can fold those up and transform him. Take this back section here. You're going to bring it in on itself. Just like this. See, there you go. Bring it in like that. separate the legs from the body, like this. You're gonna bring them down, put his knees, I think I have his knees backwards at the moment, but we'll see how that goes later. Go ahead and fold the feet out if you want to get him to stand. Take the arms, you're gonna unfold them from the body, and then you're going to, you may want to do it later, but I go ahead and do it. I take the arms and I fold them up so they are kind of going up, and when he's in his jet mode, it gives this nice little fighter type thing, but it's a fighter jet, what do you expect? Take the nose, because that was a sorry joke. Fold it down, and once you get it locked in place, there you go, he's done. Just got to rotate the arms, elbows in the front, and there you have Tread Shot. Not bad looking. He should stand fairly well, I hope. He has big feet. And now to transform Windrazer, who looks like this when he's transformed. Now, I've gone ahead and put his Energon weapons in. You can have him kind of in this gun position. You can kind of have him in this little, like, club-type look, which both work. They originally come connected like this with this little connector tab. You will need this later on. You can even, you know, connect them now. The way, you know, just one slides in the hole, one kind of clips in, and you can have this nice little, like, combo-type weapon where, you know, it's double-handed. I don't know, but it's there. And, not bad. In terms of articulation, the legs, these guys basically have the same amount of articulation for each robot. You know, the legs are on the same little joints, knees, ankles, arms can move, his hips, he has no hip movement, I'm sorry, no waist articulation, it's gone, he doesn't have it, it's taken away from him this time he was a bad boy. The head looks pretty nice, you can see the head, nice little sculpt, it does have a full 360 turn. And it's not terrible. It looks all right. It's just when he's a limb, he kind of suffers. Now, last but not least is Stormjet. Now, from what I've seen, Stormjet, it's basically an SR-71 Blackbird, but it's definitely modified quite a bit. I mean, if they had simple Earth modes, they wouldn't be that cool, apparently. Not a bad looking little jet. He's the biggest out of all of them, clearly. And he has landing gears on the bottom here. Again, the wheels do not rotate, but you can just fold the landing gears away. This one's definitely pretty cool. Now, the thing that's kind of funny is Stormjet, he is the only one of these guys who has an actual personality. It's kind of, I guess, hinted at in the show or what have you, that the smaller guys are basically drones, that their only purpose is to combine with Stormjet to make Superion Maximus. And he's known for being full of artillery. He has more weaponry than you could really imagine. Well, the funny thing is, the toy has no weapons at all. In fact, the plane mode has apparently no weaponry from what I can see. He has no Energon star. These guys came with the stars. The big guys didn't. That's kind of a ripoff. I mean, why don't they get Energon stars? But, oh well. To transform him, and he's kind of iffy. He's kind of the big eh kind of guy. So, go ahead and start. Untab the front section of the plane. You can bring it up here for now. Take his legs. You're going to bring them down. And you can go ahead and rotate them. You may have to kind of bring out the leg a little bit. I go ahead and extend the leg all the way down. Take the front section. You're going to rotate it like this. Bring it down, and then you're just going to swing this section in. It's going to peg into a little slot here. At least, I guess you could call it pegging. I mean, doesn't really securely fit. Reach inside, there's a little head in here. Tuck that down. And there are these little red panels. You're going to flip them down. You can't really see that one, can you? Okay, there you go. And these are supposed to tab into his shoulders. There's a little tab on each side, and there's a little slot in each of these gold parts on his shoulders. And it's supposed to kind of tab them in, but it doesn't really tab all that well. I mean, you can kind of work with it, but it's not really going to improve anything. Once he's there, rotate the head around, take his arms, get them down, elbows in the front like always. He has kind of these little like, gorilla-type fists, but there you have Stormjet. Overall, not bad looking. I mean, he's not drastically taller than the other bots in the air team. Almost said aerial bots, but they're not aerial bots fifth time. Nuh-uh. Just a little bit taller, not much. And he pretty much has the same articulation. Waist, there's no movements. The legs, movement, he has knees, he has no ankles. Oh, I forgot to flip out his feet, didn't I? So, Reach inside, fold these down. These will be his feet. And it will vastly improve his ability to stand. So, there he is fully transformed. Ebos have movements. You can rotate his wrist, kind of his little joint here, or little turny thingy here. The head can actually move around pretty well. Head looks pretty nice. You can kind of see it in there. There you go. There you have the Autobot Air Team. Now, to transform them into their limb modes, stand. Okay, his little legs kind of being a little weird. Oh, and one major complaint that I have with this guy, which will carry on to his next mode. The cockpit doesn't really seem to tab in all. Well, it tabs in better for this mode. It holds fairly securely, but what you will see later on, it doesn't really fit all that well in its actual combiner mode. So, there's that. And through the magic of television, I will now have all these guys, except Stormjet, transformed into their vehicle modes.
Wow.
Don't you think you could transform that easily at home? So there, here you have all of them, kind of in their next step towards becoming Superion Maximus. You're going to have the four guys back into their vehicle modes, because that's basically, I mean, these guys basically fold their wings and they're there. Little guys are the other work. So, the way the configuration worked in the show, it's going to work out where you're going to have Sky Shadow and Windrazor being his legs. So, leg, arm, and suicide. Leg. So, there's how that's going to work out. You know, you can kind of mess these guys as much as you want, do your own configuration, but the problem is, since you have two basic figures for any configuration, you're kind of... Your choices for customizing it are kind of slim. You may want to, it's just my little recommendation, you may want to work out where you have both of these guys, the A-10 Thunderbolts, being his legs, since they have a lot more stable feet. Now, this is the foot for that leg mode. This is the foot for the other leg mode, so, I'm going to transform these guys into their foot mode. This obviously works for Terra Dive as well. Rotate the wings like this. Take his foot, or take the cockpit, sorry. And you're going to rotate this down, rotate that. There's a little peg here, this little hole in the bottom. You're going to get those pegged into each other. And you get this nice little snowboardy action. Well, it's not a snowboard yet, because he's got a snowboard. And you're going to peg that in place. And there you have a foot. Not horrible, it's, you know, it's okay. I'm going to take the other one here, Windrazor. I think I'm going to forget his name. Untab his legs. Bring the front towards... Or bring the back towards the front. Sorry, I'm tired today. And it's kind of like you're going to put him into his robot mode, yet you're not. You're going to take his back legs, split them right down the middle, which looks painful. And when you swing them down, you're going to rotate his legs inward. There's a little slot here, a little tab here. And you're going to tab those together, just like this. So, repeat with the other side, get that tabbed in. And this also works for his hand mode. This is the exact same transformation for his hand mode. Just, you kind of turn his Energon niblets a different way, but, oh well. Rotate the hands around, then they're going to fit into these little pegs here on his legs. And this will make his legs a lot more stable, regardless if he's a hand or a leg. And that's how he's going to look. Take his Energon weapon. And it's going to peg into the bottom of his foot. Now, there's a little bit of a help on stability here. If you reach inside, there's these little pegs. You can see I'm kind of flipping one up here. Those are going to swing across and clip into the bottom of his foot. There's a little ridge that sticks out. I don't know if it really helps that much, but anything that'll help the figure stability is okay with me. So there you have foot number two, at least for this configuration. Now, for Stormjet... A little bit more complicated. Fold in his little feeties. Reach up. You're going to pop the whole cockpit section back up. You're going to grab his crotch piece and you're going to fold it down as far as it can go. Then rotate his legs back down. And he's just kind of flapping away here. Go ahead and fold up the little red tabs for his head. You may want to rotate his head back to its original position. I'm pretty sure it's not going to fit with him facing forward like he was. So there's this. Going to go ahead and lock the cockpit back in place for now, just get out of the way. So now that you have this here, he's just kind of a mess. take the legs, fold them back up like they were in his jet mode. And at the same time, you're going to give a little push so that the little connector pegs at the bottom are fully extended. Now, one problem with this guy is when you are connecting him, this will tend to kind of get in the way. The peg likes to go back inside of his leg, and it makes combining him kind of a challenge. But you should have it so the leg is fully extended. If it's not, you're going to have a hard time getting in locked into his legs. And there we go. It's out now. Let's see how long it lasts. You're going to take his arms, you're going to fold them in, and you're going to rotate them so they're in this kind of position. I know I didn't really show that too well, but I'll show it for the next one. You're going to rotate it so his fist fits with this peg, and also so his connector tab peg, whichever you want to call it, is on the outside here. So again, take the arm, fold it in place, rotate it outwards, and it's going to peg into his already arm. And there that is. All I have to do now is take the cockpit section, fold it back down like it was originally, lock it in place, and honestly, it barely even locks in place. This is going to pop up so much. Things are very sturdy. Watch, see? The slightest move, and oh, look, it's untabbed. So I'm hoping that this is just because it's a fairly old toy. It's like 2000 and something. I know that's not really a way to base your toy's age, but it's not a brand new toy is what I'm trying to say. You're going to go ahead and take the front section here, fold it down. There's a big head. You're going to fold this up, lock it in place, fold this back up. Again, it's come untabbed. I don't want to have to use glue on this, but if I get to that point, I may have to. Rotate the head forward, and there we have the Superion Maximus head. Very nice head. The light piping is really good on this. I still don't have my flashlight, so I can't really show it. Now, when you combine these guys for the legs, it's best to get a firm grip on something kind of in the middle, so you can just click it on. Otherwise, that peg is going to slide back in, and you definitely don't want that because it's hard to get them connected. So there's that, and there is the other leg. So now your combiner can stand, if you can call it standing. He's kind of lopsided. Let me tilt this up just a teeny. Okay, now, for Terror Dive, since he's going to be an arm, do the same thing as before. Fold the wings in. You're going to take his Energon weapon, and there's a little slot right in the middle there. It's going to fit into the cannon for his gun. Since he's going to be the left arm, going to do it this way. And there you go. There is his little limb. He does have a hand that can open and close. Looks more like a gun that's being held underneath him. We're going to take this and tab it into the socket. And there's one arm. I'm going to go ahead and transform Treadshot off camera because it's getting him back in the exact same position Windrazor was in. And now the only difference between him and the leg mode is here is the leg mode. Fold this down. And he's now got fingers. Kind of. Sort of. Maybe. But there's that. And he simply fits right into this slot here. And fold him down. And then you have Superion Maximus. Now, as you can tell, he's not the best Transformer out there. I'm going to bring this down a little bit more so you can see his feet. This is where kind of the Energon Combiner suffered, in my opinion. The robot modes separately are very good. They're definitely good in terms of articulation. They're detailed nicely. Their vehicle modes look great. When you combine them, you really lose a lot. The only reason that I can figure out for why they have these Energon limbs is that supposedly Superior Maximus' backstory is that him, Bruticus Maximus, Constructicon Maximus, and Superior Maximus' brother, who we don't know the name for, we're never giving it, were the guardians of Super Energon. In terms of articulation, his head can do a full 360. The arms can move all the way around. There's no elbow joints. His hand, you can open and close it, I guess, in theory. Same with this arm, it can move all the way around. The fingers can kind of open and close, but he looks more like he has cannon arms. The legs can bend upwards, they can bend outwards. He does have knees where the joints are connected. And he has no ankle movements. And most of the time, just to get him to stand in a decent pose, you have to kind of get this weird leaning action. And it's really hard because he keeps unpegging himself. But you have to kind of get, you know, these weird leaning poses with him just to get him to stand normally, which is definitely a sad thing. Now, the second reason why I am doing this video is because Fans Project is working on an accessory kit for this guy. It will replace the Energon weapons with actual limbs, and you'll have a whole new configuration to transform him. They even have a visor for the robot head, and the limbs actually become components for the vehicle modes. It should be a really nice set. But there you go. If you see this guy on eBay, you may want to pass him up, being that there is a brand new one out there in stores now. It's sold as a gift set. I'm not sure its retail price. It'll be under the Revenge of the Fallen figure line, whichever. The only difference is they've got more of a G1-inspired paint job for all these guys. You may want to get that one, since the figure should kind of look a little bit better. But that is it. Hope you guys enjoyed the review. Hope you have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.